Saguijo has always been the mecca of rock and roll, and as young college kids, yeah, it was like a dream to play here.
And it's also kind of like a, paano ba, parang rite of passage.
Yeah.
If you're in a band, you haven't been in the scene if you haven't played in Saguijo. And we really love playing here. The sound is different, it's so intimate. It's like you're standing right next to the people you're playing for.
For the longest time, it was like the one place we had to play as young musicians. And it's funny how it's become a home, making home base siya. So for me, that's like something so special.
I live in fear of your gear being spilled on by beer. Pero kasama yun,
that's fine.
Kasama yun, di ba?
And I think the success and failure of that night's gig depends on how many times the waiter passes you by. Kasi if there's a waiter that keeps passing you by, then it means, ah, okay, walang tao. Okay. Or it also depends on how cold it is.
Yeah. I don't remember the first time we played in Saguijo, but I do remember one of our most memorable gigs in Saguijo is our album launch as well, our first album launch. And I think we broke the record for the most sales in Saguijo that night.
I'm just so happy it looks exactly the same. It does, right?
Yeah.
It looks exactly the same. And I hope it never changes. Unless you want to make it a little bigger. That would be good too.
It's really nice seeing everything from that last gig we did. Never changed. The writing on the whiteboard outside.
There's always this, as Kyle said, there's this magic for some reason. Like there's this magic about the sound here. So it was just pure excitement.